Hi, guys. Welcome to this Liège-Bastogne-Liège briefing. There's no point beating around the bush. You're a...
Hello and welcome to Belgium for one of the most eagerly awaited classics of the year, Liège-Bastogne-Liège. With its very demanding route that takes in numerous short climbs, this monument is the holy grail for all punchers.
Guys, may be one for the punches. But it's also and especially about freshness in the closing kilometers. You've got to keep plenty in the tank for the final climbs and make no unnecessary exertions. Otherwise, you'll pay the price straight away.
One minute for the breakaway. Looking good. It's the first climb of the day. The Côte de la Roche en Ardennes. Of course, it's far too early to see an attack by any of the favorites.
The peloton is riding hard. Stay well placed.
The front of the race is now going through Bastogne, from where the riders turn back towards Liège. There are 150 kilometers left in the race. The breakaway has reached the very steep Côte de Saint-Roch, 1 kilometer on an average slope of 11%. The riders would then enter the first feed zone. The riders are now going through Vielsalm, a town that marks a new phase in the race, because from now on, climbs will come one after the other, right to the finish. A new difficulty along the riders' way with the Côte de Van, 3.6 kilometers on an average slope of 5.1%. The first riders are beginning the Côte de Stocco climb. Only 1 kilometre, but the average gradient is over 12%. After more than 170 kilometres, the distance might begin to weigh heavily on some legs. The riders are about to climb the Col du Rosier. At almost 4.5 kilometres, it's the longest ascent on the route. At the top, there will be 60 kilometers to go. Here's the Col du Maquisard. It's probably a bit early for a decisive attack, but the climb could give a clue to the condition of potential winners. With its 2 kilometers. In sections at 20%, the Côte de la Redoute is a true wall. It's a moment to turn the screw or to abandon all hope of victory.
Teammate has just been dropped. You can't count on him any longer. The breakaway will no doubt go all the way, lad, but watch out for attacks in the closing kilometers.
...30 seconds lead for the head of the race. He's trying to get out of the peloton, watch out!
Thank you.
There are two obstacles left on the menu, the Côte des Forges and the Côte de la Rochefoucauld. Penultimate difficulty of the day for the head of the race, the Côte des Forges. We'll have to keep something in reserve if we want to get away in the final kilometers. He's trying to get out. Watch out! Counter-attack at the front of the peloton. Breakaway over. He's trying to get out of the peloton. Watch out. There's only the Rochefoucauld to be climbed, and no rider has managed to shake off his opponents. The suspense is overwhelming.
If we are to hope for a stage win. Riding hard behind. This isn't the moment to relax.
Counter-attack at the front of the peloton. He's trying to get out of the peloton. Watch out. Rochefoucauld didn't see any rider make a getaway, but there's still a long rising false flat on which to edge clear. If that doesn't do it, it's likely to be decided in a sprint. The road is now free of climbs. The riders will soon be onto the big boulevards, and so it will be almost impossible to surprise one's opponents. Now it's downhill to the finish. The sprint looks inevitable. No need to ask questions. He's moving onto the attack. He's trying to get out. Watch out! Final kilometer. Victory will be decided in the sprint.
He has mastered the difficulties of the Ardennes, as well as his most determined opponents. Here is the winner of Liège-Bastogne-Liège, Alexey Lutsenko! He is now part of cycling legend. Applaud him.